So good morning students. So in today's class we are going to see the topic linear inequalities. Okay, so linear inequalities, so the topic itself I think it's familiar to you, that is we have seen about the inequalities in the last class. Okay, and linear inequalities, that is we know about linear equations, that is combining linear equations and linear inequalities we will be getting linear inequalities. That is, what is linear equation? The linear equation will be in the format f of x is equal to ax plus b. Okay, so equation means will be getting equal to 0. Inequality means less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, less than, greater. This type of symbols will be used here. That's the difference in linear equation and linear inequalities. Okay, so in this subdivision they have given some examples. See here, first itself they have given some example. Now let us see this. So our monthly electricity bill contains a basic charge which does not change with number of units used, and a charge that depends only on how many units we use. Okay, so our monthly electricity bill, this is example 2.6. okay, so the monthly electricity bill of us is contains of basic charge plus the number of units, charge for the number of units that is we are consuming. So monthly electric bill will be equal to basic charge plus some other thing, that is number of charge for units consumed, that is consumed. Okay, let us say electricity board charges rupees 110 as basic charge. So the basic charge is given as 110 plus we have to know the charge for unit consumed. Okay, and the charge is rupees 4 for each unit we consume. If a person wants to know his electricity bill below rupees 250, then what should be his electricity usage? That is, the charge for one unit is 4. So let x be the number of units that a person consumes. So the question is, a person wants to keep his electricity bill below 250. That is below 250. It should be below 250. Okay, this electricity bill should be below 250. That is basic charge plus one unit charge is 4, and the x is the number of units a person consumes. So what should be the number of units that the person should consume for making this electricity bill less than 0? We have to find x, right? We have to find x from this. Okay, shall we find x from this? See here, 110 plus 4x less than 10. Bring this 110 this side, that what it becomes, 4x will be less than 250 minus 110 is 140. Bring this 4 this side, so it becomes 140 divided by 4. So 270135. So x is less than 35. That is, the person should consume less than 35 units or less than 35 units. So okay, so the person must use the electric unit per month for him is, it should be less than 35 units. You have to write this in words, less than 35 units. Okay, now example 2.7, solve for 3x minus 5 less than or equal to x plus 1. Okay, we have to solve for this. Now see here, bring this x this side, what happens, 3x minus x less than or equal to 1, bring this minus 5 this side, it becomes plus 6. Therefore 3x minus x is 2x less than or equal to 7. Therefore x is less than or equal to, so this is 1 plus 5, right? 1 plus 5, so this is 7. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. Therefore the value of x is, the solution set is x is less than or equal to 3. Therefore shall we write this set, x is less than or equal to 3 means minus infinity comma, the solution set is minus infinity comma 3. This should be closed because they have given x is less than or equal to, if they have given less than alone we can make this as open interval, but they have given us less than or equal to, therefore we are taking this as closed interval. This is the answer. Okay, now example 2.8. What's example 2.8? Solve the following system of linear inequalities. We have to solve for this. 3x minus 9 greater than or equal to 0 and 4x minus 10 less than or equal to 6. We have to solve for this. So keep in mind that they have given and. Okay, they have given and means intersection. Okay, intersection. Keep in mind. Okay, now shall we solve this separately? 3x minus 9 greater than or equal to 0. And here 4x minus 10 is less than or equal to 6. So here bring this minus 9 this side. What happens? 3x is greater than or equal to 9. Here 4x bring this minus 10 this side. It becomes plus 10. 6 plus 10 is 16. And again here bring this 3 this side. X should be greater than or equal to 9 divided by 3 is 3. And here x should be less than or equal to 16 divided by 4 is 4. So write this in interval, x is greater than or equal to 3, that is 3 greater than or equal to, since they have given equal to, we have written in the closed interval, comma infinity. X is less than or equal to 4 means minus infinity comma 4, it should be closed. See here the question is, it should be and, that is it should be combined using intersection of a closed open interval of 3 comma infinity and open closed interval of minus 3 comma 4. What's the common term here? Common term here is 3 comma 4. This is the solution set. Common term here is closed interval of 3 comma 4. While combining this both, we get 3 comma 4 is the intersection, not combining. While finding the intersection, the common term is a closed interval of 3 comma 4. This is the answer. Okay. Now let us see the next example. Example 2.9. Okay, 2.9. A girl A is reading a book having 446 pages. The total pages is 446. Okay, and she has already finished reading 271 pages. What she have read? She have read 271 pages. Completed. Okay, 270. She wants to finish reading this book within a week. A week contains 7 days. Okay, what is the maximum number of pages she should read per day to complete reading the book within a week? Okay, maximum number, that is 446 she have to complete. 446 she have to complete. She already she have completed 271 plus 7 days ko per day ki evlo pages. So let x be number of pages that the girl should read per day. Okay, so 271 plus 7 into x. She have to complete the remaining pages in 1 week, that is 7 days. 7 into x, okay, should be equal to or less than or what is this, 446. So if the number of pages she read per day, if it is greater than the particular day, it is also fine, right? So or day konde ponde for 30 pages read pannu. If she read it then for 35 pages, if she reads 35 pages per week, sorry per day, what happens? 7 days la mudikiradha she will be completing earlier. Okay, so x greater than or equal to, adhaal minimum number dhaan kandupidikka sollirukanga. If it is maximum, no problem, she will complete a whole book before 1 week. Okay, no problem. Therefore we are using this symbol greater than or equal to. This should come this here. Okay, first you have to take let x is equal to, then only you have to write the inequality. Now shall we solve this? Bring this 271, that said what happens? 7 into x is greater than or equal to 446 minus 271. Okay, 446 minus 271. What is 446 minus 271? This is 5, this is 14, and this is 3, 175. Okay, 7x is greater than or equal to 170. Bring this 7 this side. What happens? It is 7. 7 1 is 7. 7 2s are 14. The remaining is 3. Therefore, 5. X should be greater than or equal to 25. So the number of pages, the minimum number of, this is the minimum number of pages. She can read above 25 also. Okay. So the minimum number of pages that the girl should read per day is 25 pages. We have to write that in words. Okay. Now. Okay, with this we are completing the example. Now let us move on to the exercise following that. What is the exercise number? Exercise 2.3. Okay, see here, first one, represent the following inequalities in the interval notation. Okay, you have to write the given inequalities in the interval notation. Okay, first one is x greater than or equal to minus 1 and x less than 4. See the term, it is AND. AND means, what is AND? AND means it is intersection. AND means intersection. Okay, OR means it is the union. Okay, so you see here, x greater than or equal to minus 1 means minus 1 till infinity. See here, this is greater than or equal to, therefore it should be used using closed interval. Infinity we commonly use it using open interval. Intersection x less than 4, that is minus infinity comma 4, it is less than alone, therefore we are using open interval. Now what is the common terms here? The common terms here is minus 1 comma 4. The common terms here is closed open interval of minus 1 comma 4. Now the second subdivision, x less than or equal to 5 and x greater than or equal to minus 3. Okay, x less than or equal to 5 means minus infinity comma 5, closed interval, and this is, since it is AND, we have to use intersection. X greater than or equal to 3 means it is equal to, therefore minus 3 comma infinity. Okay, now what is the intersection here? Intersection is minus 3 comma 5. Okay, and now the third subdivision, what's third subdivision? X is less than minus 1 or x is less than 3. See, it is R means it should be union. Okay, so x is less than minus 1 means minus infinity comma minus, since it is less than alone, we have to use open interval, or it is union. And greater, it x is less than or 3. See here, greater than na adhikku mela, less than na adhikku keela. So don't get confused with that. So we have to get union. Minus 3 adhikku munna adhikappuram na 3 varum in the number line. Okay, number line la minus 1 and then 0 and then 1 2 3. So the highest number is 3. While unioning this, that is while combining this, what we get minus infinity comma 3. This is the answer. Okay. Now the fourth subdivision, minus 2x greater than 0 or 3x minus 4 less than 11. Okay, see, this is R, therefore it should be union. Okay, minus 2x less than 0 means what happens? See, 2, it, when it 2 becomes here, it becomes minus x greater than 0 divided by 2, anything is 0. Okay, so while changing, x should be less than 0. Okay, yeah, while multiplying with a minus on both sides, this x should be less than 0. Union, see here, 3x minus 4, bring this minus 4 this side, it becomes plus 4. Therefore, 3x less than 11 plus 4 is 15. That is union. X is less than 15 divided by 3 is 5. Okay, so x is less than infinity, less than 0 means minus infinity comma 0. Union, this x less than 5 means minus infinity comma 5. Okay, while combining this, what we get minus infinity comma 5. Okay, this is the answer. Now the second sum, what's the second sum? Solve 23 x divided, sorry, less than 100. The first one is, first subdivision is when x is natural number. Okay, so while solving, what we get? X divided by 100 divided by 23 is 4.3. Okay, the first subdivision is if x is natural numbers. So what is a natural number? Natural number starts from 1 and it goes on like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Okay, see x is less than 4.5 means natural, we have to find solution for natural numbers. So x will be equal to natural number starts from 1, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the answer. X will be equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now see the second subdivision. The second subdivision is if x is an integer. X is an integer. Integer means z, right? So what we arrived at? We arrived at x is less than 4.3. X is less than 4.3. What is integer? Integer will be like minus infinity, comma, etc. Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, etc. to infinity. This will be, this is the integer. So less than x less than 4.3 in integer, what becomes? Minus infinity, comma, etc. Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? This is the answer for this given inequality when x is an integer. Okay? Likewise, we are having the third sum. See, third sum. Third sum is minus 2x less than, sorry, greater than or equal to 9. Okay, bring this to this side. What happens? Minus 2 greater than or equal to 9 divided by 2. 9 divided by 2 is 4.5. Okay, on my multiplying minus on both sides, what it becomes? X is less than or equal to minus 4.5. The answer is x is less than or equal to minus 4.5. So, see the first subdivision. X is a real number. So, real number it will be from minus infinity to infinity. So, from minus infinity, it is restricted to minus 4.5. Since it is less than or equal to, this will be an closed interval. Okay. Now the second subdivision is x is an integer. X is an integer. If x is less than or equal to 4.5, we have to find the values of x when it is an integer. Integer means this is an integer, right? Where x value will be from minus infinity, comma, etc. Minus 7, minus 6, minus 5, minus 4 alone. Till minus 4. Okay. And then the third subdivision is, what is the third subdivision? X is a natural number. X is a natural number. We know that natural number starts from 1, 2, 3, 4. But here the given inequality, the inequality we arrived is x is less than or equal to minus 4.5. If x is a natural number, it has no solution. It has no solution because natural number starts from 1, 2, 3 alone. But here we are getting the inequality that x should be less than or equal to minus 4.5. That is, we don't have the natural numbers in this inequality. Okay. Therefore, the answer is it has no solution. Now, the fourth sum. See the fourth sum, solve for, they have two subdivisions. See the first subdivision, 3 into x minus 2 divided by 5 less than or equal to 5 into 2 minus x divided by, okay, 3. Now see here, on cross multiplying, take this 3 this side and minus 5 this side. What happens? This goes to the numerator, both goes to the numerator. 3 into 3 becomes 9 into x minus 2 less than or equal to 5 into 5 is 25 into 2 minus x. Okay, and again bring this 9 this side and bring this 2 minus x this side. Sorry, okay. Now multiply this 9 and 25 inside. What happens? 9x minus 92 is 80 less than or equal to 25 into 2 is 50 minus 25 into x is 25x. Okay, see, bring this 25x this side. What happens? 25x plus 9x bring this minus 18 this side, less than or equal to 50 plus 18. Okay, 25 plus 9 is 34 into x, less than or equal to 68. Therefore, x is less than or equal to 2. 34, 68 divided by 34 is 2. X is less than or equal to 2. So write this in interval. What happens? Minus infinity comma 2. This is closed because it is less than or equal to. Now this again subdivision. 5 minus x divided by 3 less than x divided by 2 minus 4. Okay, x divided by 2 minus 4. Now we can take LCM here. If we take LCM 2, what happens here? X minus 8. X minus 8. Now on cross multiplying, what happens? 2 into 5 minus x less than 3 into x minus 8. Okay, 3 into x minus 8 and multiplying 2 inside, and this side you have to multiply 3 inside. What happens? 2 into 5 is 10 minus 2x less than 3x minus 3 into 8 is 24. Okay, 24. Bring this 2x that side, what happens? And minus 24 this side, 24 plus 10 less than 3x plus 2x. Okay, 24 plus 10 is 34, this is great, less than 5x, that is 5x is greater than 34. From this what we get? X is greater than 34 divided by 5. So write this in interval, x is greater than 34. See, it is not equal to, this is just greater than, therefore 34 divided by 5, comma infinity. This is the answer. Okay, now the fifth sum. It is the word problem. What is the question given? To score A grade, one must obtain an average of 90 marks in 5 subjects. Okay, there are 5 subjects. To score A grade, what they have to do? They have to score 90 marks in each, all the subjects. Okay, so 90 marks. So 5 subjects are there. The total is 100 marks. So what is the total marks is 500. To score 90%, one must get 90 mark in, to score A grade, one must get 90 marks in all the 5 subjects. That is 90 into 5, which is equal to, they must score 450. They must score 450 for getting the grade A. Okay. If one score, they have given 4 subject marks, what is the minimum mark one scored in the 5th subject to get A grade in the course? Okay, what are the marks they have scored is 84 plus 87 plus 95 plus 91. Let x be the 5th subject mark for the one person. Okay, you have to take, let x be the 5th subject mark for the one person. So while adding that, they should get equal to, either if they get equal to 450 or greater than or equal to, this therefore greater than or equal to 450. Okay, now add this all, 84 87 95 91 9 10 17 7 balance 1 19 19 16 okay then it is 15 5 balance 3 57. So this is 357 plus x should be greater than or equal to 450. Now bring this 357 that side, x should be greater than or equal to 450 minus 357. That is 450 minus 357. Okay, what happens here? It is 31. Okay, so 14 minus 5 is 90. So x should be greater than or equal to 93. Okay, x should be greater than or equal to 93. So you have to write it in words. What should it is? Therefore, one should score the minimum of 93. maximum it can be 100. So one should score minimum of 93 to get the 90% to get the A grade. Okay, you have to write the solution in words. Okay. See the sixth sum. A manufacturer has 600 liters of a 12% solution of acid. How many liters of a 30% acid should be acid solution should be added to it so that the acid contained in the resulting mixture will be more than 50% but less than 18%. Okay, so therefore 600 liters of acid mixture a manufacturer is having. Okay, so let x be the number of liters of a 30% acid solution. You have to write it. Let x be the number of liters of 30% acid solution. Okay. Now, what they have given in the question? So the resulting mixture will be more than the more than 15% but less than 18%. Okay. See here. This is 600. They are having 12% in 600. Okay, 12, they are having 12%. What is 12% in 600? 12 divided by 100 into 600, which is 72 liters. They are having 72 liters. Okay, they are having 72 liters. Now, see here, they have given in your question, we are taking excess number of liters of 30% is acid solution. Okay. The resulting mixture will be more than 15%. The resulting mixture is, they are adding to the 600 liters, right? So 600 plus x, that is they are adding to this. Resultant mixture will be greater than, okay, greater than 72 okay. So this is 15 divided by 100. That is 15% of the resulting mixture. This is greater than or equal to 72 plus 30x divided by 100. So, I hope you can understand. See here. First, let it clear. The question is, the manufacturer is having 12% of the 600 liters as a solution. So, 12% of the 600 liter is 72 liter. Okay, so in the 72 liter kuda 30% acid solution we are adding. What is 30% acid solution? That is 72 liters plus 30%, 30 divided by 100 acid solution. Number of acid solution should be added is x. So either one the less than or equal to 15% of the what I have given, 15% of the resulting mixture. So 600 liters la x vandu add pandranga adula 15% ku idu vandu less ah irukum. This is what they have given you. Don't get confused. So first 12% of 600 solution is 72 and the percentage la and the 72 liter acid solution la we are adding some 30% acid solution. So this is the acid solution percentage, this is the mixture percentage. Okay, so 600 liters irukku and the 600 liters kuda we are adding. So in the 600 liters la we are having only 12 liters as acid solution. So acid solution la rate vandu 72 but adoda liter vandu 600. So idhula enna add pandrom na x liters add pandrom. X liters la 30% vandu acid. So in the side ellame enadhu acid kanakku, in the side ellame the mixture. So in the mixture vandichina this is 15, this is less than 15%, sorry, greater than, right? Yes, more than. So this is more than 15%. Therefore the total resulting mixture order we are taking 15%, which is greater than or equal to the total acid solution. This is the solution for acid, this is the total mixture. So don't get confused. Okay, now we are going to solve this. Okay, shall we solve this? Okay, so take here 600 plus x. So on multiplying, what happens? So 9000 plus 15x divided by 100, greater than or equal to, take LCM, 7200 plus 30x divided by 100. This 100 and this 100 get cancelled. Okay, now see here it is 9000 plus 15x greater than or equal to 7200 plus 13x. Bring this 15x that side. So bring this 7200 this side. That is 9000 minus 7200 is greater than or equal to 30x minus 15x is 15x. Okay, so that is 1800 is greater than or equal to 15x. Okay, while solving, what we get is x should be less than or equal to 120 liters. And another one equality is it is 18, this is greater than, more than, and less than 18% they have given. Similarly, the same thing, 600 plus x into this is 18%. Therefore, 18 divided by 100 greater than or equal to 72 plus 30x divided by 100. Similarly, you have to move on like this. Okay. Plus 18x greater than or equal to 7200 plus 30x. The denominator x and x gets cancelled. Therefore, bring this 18x that side and this is this side 1000. What happens here? Here is 6 and here is 3600 is greater than or equal to 18. Therefore, 12 into x. This is x should be less than or equal to 300. So this is 300 liters. Therefore, the liters are 120 liters and 300 liters. This is the solution. Okay, first. It's the toughest job. So first you have to understand the question clearly. First, I will take 600 liters. That is 12% is the acid solution. So that is 12% is 72. 72 is the acid solution. The total liters they are having is 600. So x be the number of liters which should be added. So the total mixture becomes 600 plus x. That is acid content is 30. X acid content is 30%. So already we have acid content 72 plus x 30% is x 30 into x divided by 100. Okay, then total mixture 15% is greater than, likewise, and the total mixture 18% is less than. So we are calculating the answer, 120 liters and 300 liters. Okay, now the seventh sum. What is the seventh sum? See here, find all pairs of consecutive odd natural numbers, both of which are larger than 10 and their sum is less than 40. Okay, odd natural numbers. For consecutive odd natural numbers means அடுத்தடுத்து இருக்க odd numbers. So let us take first odd number is x. அதுக்கடுத்து இருக்க odd number, if it is x is 5, means the next number is 5 plus 2, that is 7. Therefore, x plus 2. So, let x and x plus 2 be the two consecutive odd numbers. You have to write in words. Okay. See what they have given. This should be, x should be greater than 10, right? Which is larger than, x should be greater than 10. And x plus 2 should be also greater than 10. Okay. Okay. And what's the next thing? And their sum is less than 40. That is x plus 2 should be less than 40. What happens? 2x plus 2 is less than 40. Okay, bring this to this side. 2x less than 40 minus 2 is 38. Bring this to this side. X is less than 38 divided by 2 is 19. X should be less than 9. And what they have given? X is greater than 10. So 10 less than 19 kulla irukra. Odd numbers. What are the odd numbers? 11, 13, 15, 17 and 19. While we add that both, it should give it should be less than 48. So if we add this food, what we get? 11 plus 13 is 24, and then 13 plus 15 is 28, and then 15 plus 17, what is 15 plus 17? 2, balance for 32, and then 17 plus 19 is 36. This all are less than 40. Therefore, the possible set is, the possible order is 11, 13, 13, 15, okay, 17, so 15, 17, and 17, 19. This is the possible solution set. You have to write the possible solution set is, okay. Now, the 8th sum. Okay. A model rocket is launched from the ground. The height h reached by the rocket after t seconds from the liftoff is given by h of t is equal to minus 5 t squared plus 100 t, where t is from 0 to 25 alone. Okay. They have restricted the value of t from 0 to 20. This is the height of the rocket that have reached after the takeoff. Okay. At what time the rocket is 495 feet above the ground? That is, they have given height 495. At what time it should get 4? So the time is from 0 to 20. At what time the height it becomes 495? Okay, what happens? You have to substitute the value of t from 0 to. So when t is equal to 0, what happens? T is equal to 0 means this becomes 0, it becomes 0. Therefore, this becomes 0. Okay, then height becomes 0. Okay, and when t is equal to 1, 1 is minus 5, height is equal to, minus 5 plus 100, which is 95. Then t is equal to 2, height is equal to 2, 2 square is 4, 4 into 5 is 20, this is minus 20, okay, minus 20 plus 200, which is equal to 180. When t is equal to 3, height is equal to 3, 3 is 9, 9 into minus 5 is minus 45 plus 300, okay, then 265, okay, it goes on like this. It goes on like this. When the value of t is 9, height will be equal to 99 is 81. 81 into 5 is 5, 405, minus 405 plus 900. 100 into t is 900. 900 minus 405 is 495. Okay, so at the value of t is 9, we get 495. Similarly, you should check for all the 20 when it goes on, and when the time is 11, t is equal to 11, what happens is 121 into 5, 5, 0 balance 1, 5, 6, 605, minus 60, h is equal to minus 605 plus 1100. This also becomes 495. Therefore, the value of t is two values. T is equal to 9 and 11. At the value of t is 9 and 11, the height reached is 495. So, you have to check for all the 20 numbers. Okay. Now, the 9th sum. See, the 9th sum is the assignment for you. So, what is the question? A plumber can be paid according to the following schemes. In the first scheme, there are two schemes. Okay, in the first scheme, he will be paid rupees 500 plus rupees 75 per hour. So, let x be the number of hours he is working. Okay, in the first scheme, what is the first scheme? 500 is the basic thing plus 70 plus per hour. So, 70 number of hours he is working is x. 70 hour. And in the second scheme, okay, in this he will be paid 120 per hour. 120 per hour. 120 into x. Okay, so if he works x hours, then for what value of x does the first scheme is the better?
First scheme is the better one, means 500 plus 70x should be greater than 120x. This is the inequality. You have to solve this inequality and you have to find the value of x. This is the question. This is the assignment for you. Okay, this is the assignment for you. Now, the 10th one, last question. A and B are working on similar job, but their annual salaries differ by more than 6,000. Okay, A and B are working in a same job. If B earns rupees 27,000 per week, per month, we have to find the possibilities of A's salary. Okay, A's salary. Okay, see, this B salary is 27,000. So A's salary, A with the A's salary. Okay, A, their difference is, their salary difference is 6,000. If A is earning highest, means A minus 27,000 B equal to 6,000. Friends, from this we can arrive that 6,000 plus 27,000. Okay, 27,000. What happens is less than or equal to. So, what they have given may differ more than 6,000. So, the less differ is 6,000. More than 6,000, it is less than or equal to. That means 6,000 is greater than or equal to some value. Therefore, A is equal to 6,000 plus. Therefore, this is 33,000. 33,000. So, A's value should be less than 33,000. And here, the next thing, the two possibilities is A must get higher salary or B must get salary. This is A, this possibility is this solution is for A is getting higher salary. The next possibility is B is getting higher salary. Then what happens here? B is getting higher salary means B salary is 27,000. Minus A should be less than or equal to 6,000. Okay, 6,000. So this is greater than or equal to, right? The difference is greater than or equal to. Okay, this is difference is greater than or equal to. Okay, and this what happens? A goes that side and this time this side. 27,000 minus 6,000 less than or equal to A. Therefore, A should be greater than or equal to 21,000. It should be greater than or equal to 21,000 or greater than or equal to 33,000. These are the two possibilities. Okay, the only one assignment, that is the 9th sum, is the assignment in this exercise. With this, we are completing this video. Let's see the next one, quadratic functions, in the next class. Thank you, students.